Hi there, Tracy Reed here with a 5-minute video tutorial, and today I'm going to show you how to add diagonal writing along the grass in this photo, in other words, around the outside of my sun. So I'm going to create a path using the pen tool here by clicking to add anchor points all the way around the edges of the photo and then around the edges of my sun. And it's super simple. You don't have to worry about adding a curve or anything to the path. Just click around the outside edges of the subject in your photo and create anchor points all the way around, following the edges of whatever's in your photo that you don't want to have text over. So I'm going to add a couple more anchor points around him, and then I'm going to finish off the path by clicking on the first point that I made originally. And now that I've finished the path, I'm going to click on my text tool. And you can see that if I just click inside the text box I just made, that it writes horizontally across the photo. And that's not what I want. I want it to write diagonally across the photo. So instead of clicking on it and creating text in it like I did, I have to choose my path selection tool, and rotate the path 45 or 60 degrees. And then once the path is rotated, now I can add my text to it, and it will be writing diagonally according to the path, not according to your view. It's still writing horizontally according to your view, but because the path is rotated diagonally, the text, when you rotate the path back, will be diagonally too. So now I'm speeding up the writing process, and you can see as I start hitting these bumps in the path that go around the outside of my sun, the words will fill up one side, and now they're filling up the other side of the path. And once I have the entire message written out, I can now use my selection tool and rotate the whole path back again so that it lines up perfectly with my subject like it did originally. And now that it's rotated back, I see that I have a little bit more room to write. So I'm going to add a few more words here to fill up the rest of the space. Once I have all of the words written, I can now change the font I'm using to more of a handwriting font. And when I do that, you can see that the font is much smaller than the typewriter font I was using originally. So I make the font bigger until it fills up the entire space, making sure that none of my words are cut off. So I have to make it a little bit smaller again. But now that I have everything written out and the words are diagonal across the page, I can do whatever I want with it. Have a great day.